Peace in war times. This is Daniel, chapter 2, Nebuchadnezzar's Dream by Zane Koch Ve Lechet Nupu. Uyu Uta Kenu Unu Unu Nupu. Nun Ethiopian year 60, Nupu embryo year 96, 11-1-2022, Utah/Jupiter day, Thursday, March of Mars hours, 8:48 p.m. to 9:58 p.m. 797 days until February 5th, 2025 AD. Daniel 2:19. Then was the secret revealed unto Daniel in a night vision. Then Daniel blessed the God of heaven. Explanation. The God Daniel is talking about is the moon and moon god Sin, Tahuti Thoth. Alright, for those who understand information and know that this is within the 6,000 year period of the moon cycle, and that Tahuti ruled the first 4,000 years. If you listen to the last video I did on Daniel chapter 7, it exposes who this god or spirit or the mouthpiece of the gods. In Nun, we know that is Tahuti and Thoth, and that the moon cycle is ruled by what? The moon. So the god that is most talked about in the Bible and active in the Bible is the moon god. That's why Aphronu said that people in the Bible was murmuring against God, whether it was Jonah or the people of Moses, etc., because the moon god and how harsh and cruel Tahuti was in his cycle of rulership. Even up to this day, people still complaining, but they don't know what gods that they're talking about. Alright. Daniel 2:20. Daniel answered and said, "Blessed be the name of God forever and ever, for wisdom and might are his." This verse needs no explanation. Daniel 2:21. "And he changeth the times and the seasons. He removeth kings and setteth up kings. He giveth wisdom unto the wise and knowledge to them that know understanding." Explanation. It is known that Tahuti is credited with creating calendars and much more things dealing with time. Days of Thoth, everything you need to know about the first Egyptian calendar. And this is Tahuti, known as the god of writing and all that other stuff. You want to know more? Just do some research. It's not that hard to find. The knowledge of the Egyptians about the calendar, the days of the year, and the months were associated with the god Thoth. Some even called the Egyptian calendar the Tutan calendar. The first month of the Egyptian year is the month of Tut, Thoth, and Tut are the same names of the gods of wisdom, arithmetic, and astronomy among the ancient Egyptians. Also, Nun signs the center of the moon has a timer in its core, and this is why the moon god is associated with time. All right, this is a part of the moon cut in half after Nun put up there, and you can see it's a timer around the moon's brain, and it says earth membrane, which is that nine clay. Okay, introduced to the nature book 2 page 56. We skip to verse 26. Daniel 2:26. The king answered and said to Daniel, whose name was Belshazzar, art thou able to make known unto me the dream which I have seen and the interpretation thereof? Daniel 2:27. Daniel answered in the presence of the king and said, the secret which the king had demanded, cannot the wise men, the astrologers, the magicians, the soothsayers show unto the king? So this shows that astrology was being used way back then, and it's still being used now. A lot of y'all just are unaware of it. This is why a lot of this, my intro videos have the planets, what time it is, what hour, what zodiac house is in, all that stuff, because it never stops. This is what we've been using for a long time to determine what the state the universe is in. The universe is a body. The stars are as organs. When mankind got involved, after that, we was telling them that they started, their reasonability wasn't that high. And so by the time we get to the present day time, people in religion are now looking at it worse than it really was. But the universes are the biggest beings that can exist. And this is why you will see in the nature books, or they talk about, you know, certain the constellations having more than one function. Daniel 2:28. But there is a God in heaven that revealeth the secrets and maketh known to the king Nebuchadnezzar what shall be in the later days. The dream and the vision of thy head upon thy bed are these. I just skipped some of the verses because a lot of it was just drawn out. It's just what he said to Daniel, or before he got to Daniel, the king was trying to figure out his dream, and his peoples couldn't tell him, and he was threatening to kill everybody. And so Daniel said, okay, I can fix it, and I can tell you what it is. So I just skipped all of that so we can get to the meat and potatoes. You want to know the ends and the little other stuff, just go to Daniel chapter 2 and just read it verse for verse. All right, Daniel 2:29. As for thee, O king, thy thoughts came into thy mind upon thy bed, what should come to pass hereafter, and he that revealeth secrets maketh known to thee what shall come to pass. Skip to verse 31. Thou, O king, sawest and behold a great image. This great image, whose brightness was excellent, stood before thee, and the form thereof was terrible. Daniel 2:32. This image here was of fine gold, his breast and his arms of silver, his belly and his thighs of brass. Explanation. Listen to Sound Right Reason. Zain Uyunupu has expressed that the word brass used in this book and the book of Revelation is deception. Brass was not invented until 500 BC. Around 500 BC, when brass was discovered, it was called mountain copper, which is composed of naturally occurring copper and zinc mixes that were melted down to form a gold metal. The ancient Romans used brass primarily for decorative purposes. During the 13th and 17th centuries, Europeans used the decorative brasses to memorialize the dead. Brass plates bearing the engraved portraits of the dead were set into the surface of tombs and often embellished with inscriptions, heraldic devices, and other designs depicting the deceased's life or circumstances. Excuse me. Alright, so let's continue. When Daniel was in the Bible, when was Daniel in the Bible born and died? Daniel was a righteous man of princely lineage and lived around about 620 to 538 BC. He was carried off to Babylon in 605 AD, BC. By Nebuchadnezzar, the Assyrian, was still living when Assyria was overthrown by the Medes and Persians. Brass was not invented until 120 years after Daniel was said to have been born. To add to that, Daniel chapter 2 was still said to have been written after as well. Either way, this word man-made metal should not be used to describe something that wasn't in existence at the time of that writing. Chapter 2, in its present form dates that no earlier than the first decades of the Seleucid Empire, 312 to 63 BCE, but its roots may reach back to the fall of Babylon, 539 BCE, and the rise of the Persian Achaemenid Empire, 550 to 330 BCE. The overall theme of the book of Daniel is God's sovereignty over history. So this is Daniel chapter 2. So once again, the fact that this is what we mean when you need to pay attention to certain things, because if they put a word in there that didn't of a metal that didn't exist, And that's small, but it still caused a lot of problems in other places. And if they did that with the little word like brass, you know, what else can be wrong? You know, it's just like, you know, you try to move one thing and then it just make everything, it jumbles up everything else. And that's why I said in Revelation, there's plenty of Christians or people that like to run with that Revelation quote about, the, you know, the Son of Man had brass. It was as if it was burned in the furnace. How can you use something that wasn't there? And if we roll with them saying 2,000 years ago, come on. It's just, it's a man-made element. You understand? But we know that the book of Revelation was written 6,000 years ago. So that's why I'm saying that. Because 2,000 years ago just put you still after 500 BC. But we know for a fact the Caucasian race came 6,000 years ago. And that their parents, the Hindus, were put on the Aegean Islands. And Patmos is in the Aegean Islands, and that was one of the places that they were, and that's when the book of Revelation was given to them by Tahuti to the leader of the Cain race, which is the albino children of the priests and nuns. Daniel 2:33. His legs of iron, his feet part of iron and part of clay. Daniel 2:34. Thou sawest till a stone was cut out with our hands, which smote the image upon his feet that were of iron and clay, and brake them to pieces. Daniel 2:35. Then was the iron, the clay, the brass, the silver, and the gold broken to pieces together, and became like the chaff of the summer threshing floors, and the wind carried them away, that no place was found for them, and the stone that smote the image became a great mountain and filled the whole earth. Daniel 2:36. This dream, and we will tell the interpretation thereof before the king. Daniel 2:37. Thou, O king, art a king of kings, for the God of heaven hath given thee a kingdom, power, and strength, and glory. Daniel 2:38. And whosoever the children of men dwell, the beasts of the field, and the fowls of the heaven, hath he given into thine hand, and hath made thee ruler over them all. Thou art his head of gold. Daniel 2:39. And after thee shall arise another kingdom inferior to thee, and another third kingdom of brass, which shall bear rule over all the earth. Daniel 2:40. And the fourth kingdom shall be strong as iron, forasmuch as iron breaketh in pieces and subdueth all things, and as iron that breaketh all these shall it break in pieces and bruise. Daniel 2:41. And whereas thou sawest the feet and toes part of potter's clay and part of iron, the kingdom shall be divided, but there shall be in it of the strength of the iron, forasmuch as thou sawest the iron mixed with miry clay. Daniel 2:42. And as the toes of the feet were part of iron and part of clay, so the kingdom shall be partly strong and partly broken. Daniel 2:43. And whereas thou sawest iron mixed with miry clay, they shall mingle themselves with the seed of men, but they shall not cleave one to another, even as iron is not mixed with clay. Daniel 2:44. In the days of these kings shall the God of heaven set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed, and the kingdom shall not be left to other people, but it shall break in pieces and consume all these kingdoms, and it shall stand forever. For as much as thou saw that the stone was cut out of the mountain with our hands, and that it break into pieces, the iron, the brass, the clay, the silver, and the gold, the great God hath made known to the king which shall come to pass hereafter, and the dream is certain, and the interpretation thereof sure. Then the king Nebuchadnezzar fell upon his face and worshiped Daniel, commanded that they should offer an oblation and sweet odors to him. Daniel 2:47. The king answered unto Daniel and said, of a truth it is that your God is a God of gods and a Lord of kings and a revealer of secrets, seeing thou couldst reveal this secret. Daniel 2:48. The king made Daniel a great man and gave him many great gifts and made him ruler over the whole province of Babylon and chief of the governors over all the wise men of Babylon. Daniel 2:49. Then Daniel requested of the king, and he set Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego over the affairs of the province of Babylon. But Daniel sat in the gate of the king. Listen to Zane Kotzvei Lechet Nupu Soundright Reasoning. This video is not about the kingdoms the Bible editors focus on, because there were more than just those four empires that existed in a 6,060 years extension, 4038 BC to 2022 AD, which is today, 11/3/2022. This would include King Amenubi Rehorakhti, aka Menes, aka Epidemic, aka Hermakis, aka Heru, aka Horus, aka Amen Re, aka Neymar, aka Tar, aka Jupiter, aka Manu to the Hindus, aka Brahma to the Hindus. And this is a picture of Epidemic here to the left. And this is King Menes, another image of the same one. This was the rule of Kemet's first dynasty, as well as the rule of Africa and Asia 6,060 years ago, and was the guardian over the Adam and Eve priests and nuns that lived in the Gulf of Aden until they were kicked out to Aegean Islands by King Amenubi Rehorakhti. And this is the Gulf of Aden. You can look it up. This is the location of the Adam and Eve group called Eden in the Bible. These were the parents of the Caucasian race. All right, this is right here, the Gulf of Aden. All this Yemen, all that's part of Africa. All right, Aegean Islands were the Black Hindu Adam and Eve groups were sent to 6,060 years ago by King Amenubi for breaking the law of the sun god Amun-Ra, Jupiter. Now we get to explaining what this statue means. This is what most religious people believe about this statue. So they believe that the head was Babylon, the arms were Medo-Persia, the waist part over the border, the knees was Greece, the Rome was like the legs, the top part, and the feet was Europe. Another one, they'll say that it's the same as something. When you get down here toward the feet, they say that that was the United States and the United Nations. What this writer will expose is us, the orbs, who was behind the rise and fall of these old kingdoms, as well as these current ones that will be final February 5th, 2025, and restart the African Noon Kingdom in 2029 AD, and any other mankind races that will follow in the footsteps of the African Noon Kingdom. The Universal Noon Unification Kingdom of Nature by Reason. Listen to reason. After Armageddon, the climax war for balance, equality, and justice for persons, places, and things, there will exist the Universal Noon Unification Kingdom, Tanuk, of planet Earth, and this part of the planet Earth kingdom will be all around on all Earth and will include the African Noon Kingdom, the Phoenician Noon Kingdom, the Indian Noon Kingdom, the Mongolian Noon Kingdom, the Mingalese Noon Kingdom, and the Caucasian Noon Kingdom, all right? And the acronyms called TANK, TINK, TINK, TONK, TANK, and TUNK. Of course, the word and name Noon means Nous, No, Novenary, Nobility, and North. The words in parentheses may be used as diminutives or abbreviation of the kingdom, and their pronunciations are TANUK pronounced TUNIKI, TONK pronounced TANKI, TINK pronounced TINKI, Tink pronouns ten key. The unification kingdom continues. Tonk pronounced Tonki, Tank pronouns Tain key, and Tunk pronounced Tun key. Let it be remembered always and let it be known. Introduction to the Nature of Nature book, 2 pages 266 to 267. Now let's explain what Daniel really saw. Alright, this is the head right here. The gold head represents the sun, Jupiter, and Saturn, which are all suns scientifically, referred to the books of Utah, part 6 through 7. All right? You can find this on my YouTube. And it touches on all of that about Jupiter and Saturn being suns and not stars, but they are suns. We see this evidence in the planet symbol chart. Planet symbols. See? Planet in here is sun, right? And this symbol is gold. So here you go right here. See, that's gold. Remember, everything is dealing with the orbs. All right, now we have the arms that were silver. The silver arm represent the moon. See? Now we in the waste part. Listen to reason. Remember, brass didn't exist. Brass is made up of zinc and copper. The planet that represents copper is Venus. Again, these are the orbs that are also mentioned in that February 5th, 1962 alignment. All right, so copper is the symbol of Venus. All right, we get to the bottom part, the knees or the legs and the feet. Finally, the feet are mixed with iron and clay. The planet that represents iron is Mars. Of course, she being a warrior, medals and all of that, but there you go. As you all read, it should be clear that all this is Sabaism, star worship, also called astrolatry and astrotheology, orb worship, also called pantheism or planet theism by this writer. Before we the orb stop this transmission, this is how the statue is drawn to look at destroying and to look at the stronger the statue, which were in actually earthly kingdoms and in the past and in this day and time and the underworld you haven't seen beneath your feet that meant you no good. All right, so this is what you'll see all the time when they show that this statue is being destroyed, which we know are kingdoms. But this is how a lot of people draw this particular drawing, and it's because of this quote. Thou sawest till that a stone was cut out without hands, which smote the image of his feet that were of iron and clay and break them into pieces. That stone that is cut without hands to destroy these kingdoms or asteroids that our Jupiter was seeing starting February 5th, 2029 AD. And scientists have already proven that Jupiter can do that. Jupiter is flinging asteroids at Earth like a sniper, scientists reveal. And I already covered this in the Books of Jupiter video. Listen to Sign Right Reason. We started at 3 south or 0 degrees and moved counterclockwise degree by degree to 0.6 east or 180 degrees, then further upward to 0.9 north or 360 degrees. Now we go to 0.6 west or 540 degrees of the smash circle of order, doing degree 540, excuse me, or at its completion. The 0.6 west cataclysm arrives. Nonetheless, after the smash circle of order gets started, that is to say, after it begins with conception of the universes of absolute nature, this big order has 80 circle cycles to go before the cataclysm that begins disintegration of the universe's advent. The 0.3 south cataclysm is called the solids cataclysm because it destroys persons and things by using, look, solid objects like parts of what? Earth, stones, rocks, asteroids, comets, meteors, volcanoes, earthquakes, fire and brimstones, man-made objects, solid objects picked up by tornadoes and other storms, etc., etc. Let it be remembered, let it be known. Introduction to the Nature, Book 3, page 96 of the PDF. Truman the Cosmic Peace in Wartime. Heartbroken, now you find me back. Rayon B.